Let's also take a look at how this can affect the results on a simple set of data using age and income as the two variables that we could use to build out a model. To start with, we're going to create a scatter plot that compares the age and income in each survey response for all the data without eliminating any of the observations. We can reuse the workflow we created in the quiz. We'll drag a scatter plot tool onto the canvas and configure it by setting age as the X field and income as the Y field. Click on the Plot Elements tab and deselect the Smooth Line option, as we don't need any smoothing, we just want the original regression line. Attach a Browse tool and then run the workflow to create the scatter plot. When we look at the result, we can see a scatter plot that compares age and income in each survey response for all the data without eliminating any of the observations. Without getting into too much detail of the scatter plot itself, we can see the income tends to trend up as age increases. We'll run the workflow again with a second scatter plot added after the data set, where we removed all the records that had a null in any one of the fields. We can see that the new scatter plot has a relationship between age and income that's fairly flat. This could obviously make a significant difference in the model you build and give inaccurate results. Let's test our knowledge of scatter plots and missing data with a quiz.